Good afternoon, ladies and gents. You're a good-looking rooster, aren't you? How are you feeling?
Confident.
Oh, confident. Oh, he said it's a lie. So it's really a lie? How are you really feeling?
Nervous.
She's in the car park and she looks absolutely stunning. Took my breath away, so you're a goner.
I love your smile. I love your eyes. Your kindness. I love how understanding you are. Your loving nature. Your deep care and love for family. Your wittiness, which isn't great. Your clumsiness. Your back massages. Your confidence. Your sarcasm. It's cute. Your listening skills when I complain about work. And I love your determination.
I love your dry humour. I love your patience. I love that you never let me go to sleep without saying I love you. I love that you always put me first. I love your work ethic. I love the feeling of safety you give me. I love that you do all of the chores I don't like doing. I love that you fit perfectly into my family. I love that you answer my millions of phone calls every day. And I love, love, love your legs.
Jamie, do you come here today of your own free will to take Nikki to be your lawfully wedded wife? Will you love, honour and cherish her in good times and in bad? Do you promise to protect her of her fear of the dark for as long as we both shall live?
I do.
Nikki, do you come here today of your own free will to take Jamie to be your lawfully wedded husband? Will you love, honour and cherish him in good times and in bad? And do you promise to stay true to him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
I call upon the persons here present to witness that I, Jamie, take you, Nikki, to be my lawfully wedded wife. When I thought of wedding vows, I couldn't help but think of A-E-I-O-U. It filled my mind every time I tried to write them. So instead of having to think of everything, I use them as inspiration. I'm not a very creative person, but I can definitely write a killer haiku. So here goes nothing. A is for authentic. Since our first date to our last, you have been nothing but authentic and real. You aren't afraid to speak your mind and be heard, which is a quality that I adore. E is for empathy. You pretty good, eh? You have deep empathy for the people around you. You can feel other people's struggles and worries and can make them feel at ease in any situation put before you. A day doesn't go by where you don't make me feel loved and wanted. I is for indecisive, a quality we both share. For all the dinner dates and movie dates that have gone amiss due to the lack of decisiveness we share, I love you even more. O is for outgoing, a quality I first feared but grew to love. You taught me that someone getting my order wrong at the McDonald's drive-thru is not actually okay. I'm not the most outgoing person, but you are, and I wouldn't have it any other way. Last but certainly not least is you for unconditional, which is the love I have for you. I promise to love you unconditionally in sickness and in health, and through the bad and the good. Making these promises is the easiest decision I've ever made, because vowing to love you is something I did the night we chatted each other to sleep on Sinead's couch over 3 years ago.
I call upon the persons here present to witness that I, Nikki, take you, Jamie, to be my lawfully wedded husband. Jamie, I know I'm not the easiest person to put up with sometimes, and I'm always indecisive, but I stand here today making a decision I've never thought twice about, the decision to become your wife. From day one, it's always been you. We didn't need to find our compatibility, and family visits were never a test for suitability. I've always wanted to find a love that would complete me, but from day one, you've taught me I was already whole. We've gone so far together, but please remember, you are and always will be my greatest adventure and my home. I vow to always love and respect you. I vow to help you through your highest and lowest moments and be the one who shows the world how amazing you are. I vow to be your rock and a shoulder for you to cry on. I'll try not to laugh at your singing and always remind you how good you are at dancing. But most importantly, I vow to stand by your side forever and always as your wife.
With this ring, I marry you and bind my life to yours. It is a symbol of my eternal love, my everlasting friendship, and the promise of all my tomorrows.
This ring is symbolic of my never-ending commitment, my love, and my devotion to you.
By the authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Australia, I have the honour and privilege of being the first to declare you, Nikki and Jamie, husband and wife. You may now kiss your beautiful bride.
to my son-in-law. Welcome to your family, officially. Jamie, you're an amazing, grounded, hard-working young man. From the first day we met you, we were never in doubt that you would care, love, and our daughter as we do. I know at times this can be a challenge, but challenges make us stronger and our love deeper. I love you both.
As a father of a daughter, many of you would know and would appreciate how difficult it is when boyfriends come along. Luckily for us, when Jamie came along, we had no worries or anxieties. They just simply weren't there. Leanne and I realised at an early stage that Jamie was certainly not the run-of-the-mill boyfriend. We both found him to be one of the most, the nicest, funniest, and caring young men we've ever met. We are proud to have you in our family and to finally be able to call you our son.
The most thing I'm proud of when it comes to Slim is his decision making. Nikki is a testament to that. She clearly brings out the best in him, because before he met her, he wouldn't leave the house.
Over the years, we have become closer and have created such a close bond with one another, and I am so, so happy that my best friend has met someone so caring and passionate as you, Jamie. Lastly, I would like to say a huge thank you to both of you for choosing me to be a part of your special day. For choosing me to be a part of your special day, I will cherish this day for the rest of my life.
I wish you all the very best for your future together and want you to continue to love and appreciate one another always. The world is your oyster. Wishing you the happiness always. Thank you.
The love we've felt not only today but for the last 3.5 years has been nothing short of incredible. Standing by Jamie's side has been one of my greatest moments in life, and now to finally call him my husband is a dream come true. There's one man in this room that I couldn't love anymore, and if you haven't guessed already, that's my dad. If I ever had a goal in life, it was to find a man who could love as deeply as my dad, a man who could protect me and help me conquer the world just how my dad does. And Daddy, I stand here today reading you the words on this piece of paper that I've read over and over again, just to tell you, I found a husband I hope you're incredibly proud of. A husband who loves me like you do, and a husband I'm going to conquer the world with. And last but not least, my husband Jamie. You are the reason I believe in myself. You have become my saving grace and my fighter of all my demons. You have shown me what it's like to love myself. You've taught me how to smile and laugh and always to find the positives in life. You have tried to teach me how to be patient, but I'm telling you today, you need to stop. And I cannot wait to start our journey as husband and wife.
I'm not too good on this kind of stuff, so pretty much what she said. You look beautiful tonight, as always. We've been through quite a bit together, but not everything. So I can't wait to start the rest of my life, our lives, as husband and wife. Let all the fun that comes.
Friend.